doing a video on Ben's wheelchair. Loads of people ask me about Ben's wheelchair because you don't see it around very often. And quite a few people asked for a review on it. When I actually went to get the wheelchair, I couldn't find anything online, and like loads of other people, I always rely on YouTube reviews and things like that. So I thought it might be quite good if I do a review to and do one online. Sorry, my dogs are like being absolutely nutters. So yeah, I apologise in advance for the state of my kitchen. We haven't built it where it's done, so like everything's just shoved and it looks like a complete dive. And also the quality of my camera's not brilliant because my phone is broken, so I'm having to use my laptop. Any more questions, just leave them in the comments below and I'll try my very best to answer as best as I can. A couple of things I want to say about this wheelchair. This is the best wheelchair we've ever had, and Ben's had three. We had the Amazer Bug, which was kind of like a pushchair, special needs pushchair. It wasn't really like a wheelchair, but we really didn't get on with that one at all. The wheels kept breaking off the front. It was just bumpy. The harness broke. And I don't know whether that was just the one I had, but I didn't get on with it very well. And then we have got a regular wheelchair with the big wheels that he can push around himself, but that is literally just so we can get in and out of smaller cars, and also because now he's a little bit more able to walk around himself with a walker and things, he's a little bit more able-bodied, if you like. So for quick trips, that one is fine, but we actually use this one here, which is the R82 with the R82 multiframe with the xpanda futura seat, which is a bit of a mouthful. He uses this one for school. This is the one that we use in the car with the transport and any buses that he goes on. This is the one that we use like all the time. He does have lateral supports on it, and he does have a safety net harness, which means that if he extends his legs out and stuff, he can't get out of it, but he also can't strangle himself with it, which he used to have a really bad habit of trying to choke himself. Thankfully, he has grown out of that because he's frightened me to death. But yeah, he does have that on. There are loads of other options that you can have on this, so don't just assume you only get what you see here. I've literally got to Ben's specification. You can get things like the zip front harness, the crisscross harness, you can get the Houdini harness, you can get loads of different lateral supports, headrest, no headrest. You can even get a different frame, which is still called the multiframe, I believe, but it's got the manual wheels on, so that if they want to go around themselves, but there is also the parent handle as well if they get tired. But you can find everything on the website. They don't do a rain cover and they don't do a basket, but they do a tray for oxygen, I believe, but we don't need that, so I'm not sure on that one. If you are looking for a rain cover, go to the Glenmore website. I think they're £88, about £10 postage and packaging, but I did find that the £10 ones in Boots fit just on his wheelchair, but he's only little, so it won't fit if he has a bigger seat. Ben has the size 2 seat. So anyway, I'm going to just quickly show you as best as I can all the bits on it. Okay, so we've got, this is the seat, and this is the frame, obviously. Ben has the headrest, and it can come off completely, or you can just, you might shift it up and down. This is the harness that Ben has. Which you can just take off. It's a 4-point harness, so you know it kind of just goes across like this on the side. He also has a lap belt, which you can see here, which is really good. You can also get the little bits that go in between the leg, the lateral, whatever that bit's called. So if your child hyperextends, which Ben does do, but he actually likes his wheelchair, so not so much in this one, you can get that there. All these lateral supports can be taken out, and they can be changed to your specifications. You can add more, take some out, or whatever. These come off, so if you want to take them off if he doesn't want the armrests on, or you can adjust them. It comes in 4 different colours. I think it comes in green, grey, pink, blue, and orange. I think. What else does it do? It has a footrest which goes up and down. It has got the foot feet are like this, it really does hurt his legs, so we keep them nice and straight. You've got these come as standard, these are the hooks that go into your car or bus or whatever. What else is on here? The handle, so you can, you can't, unfortunately, adjust the height wise, which is a bit of an issue because my partner's 6'6" and I'm 5'4", which is a nightmare, but this is quite high anyway. You can do things like this, like up, or like if Ollie, for example, has him, he has it a bit lower. Another really nifty tip is this, there's a little catch on here which I'll show you in a minute. If, for example, you're doing a lot of shopping, and you've got, I've been into Argos and bought kids toys or whatever, and wanted to shove them down here, you do this, and then this. You've got that little bit more extra room. It doesn't affect the wheelchair at all. It literally just needs you extending the, changing the height of the handle or whatever. So it's great for shopping and things. And then it just goes up like that. You have got the tilting space as well, which is a tiny little button. This doesn't come with it, unfortunately. This is my little bag cabin or whatever. But tilting space, it doesn't recline. This is as low as it goes, so if your child needs to sleep, this frame is not ideal. Having said that, this is the compact frame, and this is a smaller frame they do. So if you've got the bigger frame, it may be a case that it would actually recline all the way, although I can't say it would actually recline. Sorry to do that. yeah, that's better. Yeah, so having said that, I can't tell you whether you can get a full reclining one. I've no idea. But it will take a lifetime. And that's as far off as it goes. Ben usually has that a little bit because it does headbang, which you can see that he's dented complete with the foam pad on it. Constantly having to replace these. However, it is very protected, so he won't actually hurt his head, so don't panic. Some people go absolutely spare because Ben really does bang his head, especially when he's frustrated. But he's absolutely fast, so don't panic. You can take these covers off so they're nice and easy to wash. And then you've got anti-tips, which are a godsend, especially if you have a shed load of shopping on that. Or a 9-year-old hanging off the end. Then you've got your brakes. So, you know, they're pretty good, pretty sturdy brakes. Yeah, and then so obviously you've got your car hooks here and your car hooks here. And then to fold it down, you have a little catch here and a red slider thing here. You unslide the red thing, you pull this out. It clicks twice, and then you take that out. Fortunately, that doesn't fold down anymore. That's as small as that goes. And then you fold it down, press that thing in, handle it like that, and then lift it up. And this is a steel frame chair. It does weigh 5 stone, so please be warned. And that is 5 stone the whole thing. So you need some good muscles. I need to lift it up. Yeah, so including Ben, it weighs 8.5 stone, and lugging it up constantly is not easy. So yeah, then just to put it back on, you should do the same in reverse. It has got all the little clips here to alter it. So, you know, you can alter your lap belt, your strap. There are 2 settings for your height things, just like you would get in a regular children's car seat. Yeah, there's loads of little faffy little things going on here. I don't think I've missed anything. They are pneumatic tyres, isn't it? They're called the ones that you don't have to blow up if you get to, well, they won't get a puncture because, I don't know, but they don't get a puncture. They go country walking and we've never been on this 2 years, no problem at all. This is a size 2. He is going up soon to the size 3, it's a little bit bigger. This is the compact frame, but it will go right up to adulthood, even if it is the compact frame. So if, for example, you've got a child as big as Ollie, he can still sit in it. You simply just change the seat to the different size. I mean, as you can tell anyway, there's a little bit of a gap here between these two. So it's quite a wide...
Can you see that?
You know, sort of a... But yeah, but as we missed on this, I'm not sure about any added extras. You can go on the website and just shop around. Glenmore's a really good website. The rake and the footrest and things. But yeah, other than that, we absolutely love this chair. We won't change this chair. This is brilliant. It is sturdy. I mean, this chair has been pushed around. It's been country walked. We've been to the beach. We've been everywhere. If you just take a bash in, I mean, burn bankers are really hard on this thing. So this poor chair has lasted, and it's lasted in, I think we've had it 2 years now, I think. 2.5 years. So yeah, it is a really, really good chair, and I absolutely love it, and I can't recommend it enough. So yeah, I hope that's been of use for somebody. So any questions?